occasion of the Heart Day, we reinforce our pledge to have a healthy heart, both ourselves and to help our near and dear ones to have a healthy lifestyle, healthy heart, and avoid heart diseases. As you must be knowing, Indians are more at risk of a heart disease than the Western population. So basically, the Western culture of having outside food, sedentary lifestyle, increased weight, obesity, it does not suit our genes. We have a tendency to develop a heart disease. So what can be done? In your age and in your generation, as we go on with our lives, you will be faced with many such days and many such times wherein you will be required to have food outside, drinks outside, and have a more sedentary lifestyle in view of the fact that now everything is going virtual. You will be having a lot of many virtual classes, virtual courses, more screen time, more chair time, and less of physical activity. So proactively, you have to take care of your heart and your lifestyle. Keep your physical activity going, despite the fact that you're spending many hours in front of your computer, your laptops, and your books. But at the same time, you must continue your games, your sports, your physical activity, physical exertion. Everything is very important to have a healthy heart. Also in diet, fried food is supposed to be unhealthy for heart. So avoid as much as possible. You must avoid a fried food. I will give examples. I have seen children like French fries very much and pizzas very much. And these are very unhealthy for our genes. So as far as possible, you must avoid this. Home food is the best food. Indian home food is supposed to be very good for having a healthy heart. So you must have food, homemade food at times whenever it is possible. As young responsible citizens, not only your health, but your near and dear ones and your parents, your grandparents who have now entered the age wherein the possibility of heart disease is very much. So, few important points which I would want to make. One is a knowledge of heart symptoms. So, a patient having a heart disease will complain of exertional chest pain, exertional chest discomfort. That means when a person with heart disease is walking, he's climbing stairs, walking in cold weather, then they are more likely to have chest heaviness, chest discomfort, also radiating pain towards jaw, towards arm. So those are symptoms of heart disease. Also, exertional breathlessness. Breathlessness while walking, while running, while climbing stairs, cold weather. That is very important symptom of heart disease. Loss of consciousness or increased heart beating, which we call palpitation. So those are the important symptoms of heart disease. You must have a number of your nearby hospital, the emergency number, ambulance number, and keep it in your home for everyone to know, so that in case of an emergency, you can immediately call up the hospital or an ambulance or an emergency and avoid a long-term consequence. The other thing is there are a lot many online courses which are now available which teach you CPRs. CPR is cardiopulmonary resuscitation. In patients having acute heart emergency, you would require to do a CPR. A knowledge of CPR is very important for our younger generation. So online CPR courses can be done. They are free of cost. I will request everyone to attend such courses, so that you are well equipped in dealing with emergency. So that is all that I will say for now. Have a healthy heart, healthy lifestyle, stay fit, stay healthy. Thank you very much. a very happy World Heart Day to you. Thank you. I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take good care of my heart.
I pledge to take care of my heart.